In order to switch meter on or off, you press and hold power button. To quickly check signal levels, we go to cable modem. The cable with the signal must be connected to the right port of the meter. You press connect and wait until everything is loaded. Results will be in the bottom right. To exit to the main screen, you press X or home button. On every single job, we must perform 3 tests. For that, we go to heap, west central must be selected and hit next. Then hit ground block. For the low ingress test, we unplug cable from the meter. This test is used to measure noise in the cable. By unplugging it, we guarantee perfect results with no noise. When test is done, we press next. So the second test is a channel scan. For this test, unplug the cable and keep it unplugged till we're about halfway through. To help yourself, you can place a marker. The progress bar here on the bottom. By tapping on the screen, you move the marker. Marker shows the signal at the current spot. As we can see, the progress bar about at the center. So we plug the cable back in. We only need a couple of the dark blue channels in order to pass this test. As you can see, we got some. At this point, we can unplug. By tapping on the screen and moving the marker, we can see each channel in details. On the bottom right, you can see all of the data. We don't want to see any red channels. If you do have red channels, you need to lower it by using splitter or filter. We're gonna press back to see if the test is over. As soon as cable modem test starts, we need to plug the cable back in. So that's the cable modem test again. We already seen it today from the main menu. The only difference, this one gonna be uploaded to the spectrum to see. You wait until everything fills up here and press next. Then on this screen, you wanna see pass, 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 and hit next as well. The next mandatory test is a CPE test. Technically, we're supposed to do it by the modem. The other one was supposed to be at ground block. But again, to do things faster, we don't do it. Same thing here. I prefer to unplug the cable when we start the test and plug it back in when test is halfway through. Once again, technically, we're supposed to keep it plugged in throughout all of the tests, but we're speeding things up by doing this. We see that progress bar approaching the center. Time to plug the cable back in. Now we just wait for the dark blue bars. We are waiting for the internet channels. This on the screen is not internet. By placing the marker, we can see zoomed in image on the bottom. Oh, here's one. Then it's time to unplug. If we want to see, for example, this zone, we place the marker here. Then we can see the zoomed in image of the same signal. Don't worry about yellow channels. Also, if you want to see details on particular channel, you just click on it. And you can see all parameters here on the bottom right. Here is the downstream labeled as level, and here upstream labeled as MER. Press back. Get ready to plug the cable for the cable modem test. Oh, cable modem started, plugging the cable. Once again, not gonna wait until it's completed, but you wanna see everything filled up and then you can press next. Hitting next. That's it, 2 mandatory tests are completed. Also remember, if you laid new on the ground line, you must do TDR. Further, if you ever think the line is cut, you can use TDR once again to check if it's cut. Remember, when you do TDR, the drop must be by itself disconnected from everything and connected to the left port of the meter. It's actually very simple to perform TDR test. Pretty much the matter of pressing OK, 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 OK. Once you're gonna select tap and once you're gonna select ground block. At the end, you should see the results of the drop length. After that, we completed all mandatory tests. We can hit next, then save and upload. Important, in order to be able to upload anything from the meter to the server, meter must be connected to the internet by performing cable modem test prior uploads. If you reconnected the cable to the meter, you must redo the cable modem test. Okay, enough talking, let's press save and upload. I'm currently off today and have no job on me, but you can get this error in the field as well. It pretty much says the meter can't see the job information and we have to type it in manually. Well, not a problem for us, we just click here and type in work order number. You can get it from your tech mobile app. Almost always it starts with the 100. I'm just gonna type random just to test, but you gotta do it correctly. Hit apply and OK. That's it, it should save and upload right now. If for some reason it didn't go through and you got an error like this one. One of the reasons why this error appears is meter not being connected to the internet. Also not an issue for us, all of the files are saved, we just press OK, now we just need to upload it. To update meter or upload files, meter must be connected to the internet. I just explained to you one of the ways through coaxial cable, but there are two more, through RJ45 physical internet cable or through the Wi-Fi. To connect meter to the Wi-Fi, we press on this error, then on the bottom left the button with the V. In this new menu, we select Bluetooth Wi-Fi, then click on Wi-Fi on the top right. Then to scan Wi-Fi access points, we press scan. Then from the list, you select either customer's Wi-Fi or your phone's hotspot. You select the name, then you click on connect AP, then you type in the password and hit enter. After you connect it, the R server button will appear on the bottom right. Click on it. Then, when this page loads, we press upload. Then it will show you the list of the all jobs saved on meter. There is no job number or any useful information, so we guide by looking at the date on the right side and the star symbol on the left. If your job doesn't have star symbol, that means this job is not uploaded. So we search here for the job with no star. Watch out, there's more pages. You can switch pages by clicking arrows on the bottom. Here I'm scanning for all of the jobs. I see one job with no star. That means this job did not upload. I select it by checking the checkbox. Then I click on the error on the top right. If you ever don't have right side menu, that's how you open it. Then upload button will appear. Click on it. Couple more seconds and job will upload. Thank you, we done.